This video covers context-sensitive editors, keywords, valid names, and special characters. Most of the editors that use for programming languages are context-sensitive editors, meaning they automatically do the indentation for you and change the color of the text based on the programming language. Here's an example for C or C++ where blue indicates a keyword, that's a word that's reserved by the language, green is a comment, red is a literal value, and black has no special meaning to the compiler. For example, the keywords if and else are part of the C and C++ language. These words are used as part of the if statement, and they have special meaning and cannot be used as identifiers or variable names in your programs. The next slide gives examples of keywords for the C language, and then the next slide after that gives samples of keywords that are added with the C++ language. Don't worry about memorizing all these keywords. Since you have a context-sensitive editor, if it shows up in blue, then you know it's a reserved word or a keyword. The next thing I want to cover is valid names. You can choose how to name your objects and your functions and your variables and your constants. There's only a few rules you have to follow. First thing is you cannot have any spaces in your name. You can use the underscore so that it's sort of like a space, but as far as a computer is concerned, it's still one solid name. You can also capitalize the first letter in each English word and still put them all together so that it starts off with a capital letter in each word, but still it's all together in one piece. Here's a chart with sample valid variable names, the good, the bad, and the ugly. Int score, int my underscore score, int capital MY capital score, int July 4, but you can't do 4 July. Here's some bad ones. Int my space score, you can't have a space. Int grade percent, illegal character. Int first test, no good, it starts with a number. And here's ugly. Int P, well, what does that mean? Or int temp, does that mean temperature or temporary? And here's another thing to consider, is that uppercase letters and lowercase letters are considered as totally separate letters in C and C++. It's kind of like we have 52 letters in the alphabet, 26 capital letters and 26 lowercase letters. These languages, they don't make a difference between A, big A, and little A, so it's like they're two completely separate characters, so you kind of have to remember that. So when you define a variable, if you use a capital letter, it has to be a capital letter when you use it later. Since you can do that, some people think, wow, you know, I can use capital letters for one variable, and I'll use the same name, but I'll use a small letter to start it. Well, that gets kind of confusing, so try to avoid that, like temp with a capital T, and then temp that starts with a lowercase t. Well, it confuses people. As far as a computer is concerned, they're totally different. When building a program, a lot of times the compiler will create its own internal names. Usually they'll start with an underscore, just to keep them separate from the ones that you are creating. So avoid starting a name with an underscore because the compiler might try to use the same name also. The C and C++ languages use almost every character that's on the keyboard. I think what happened is when the developers of the original C language were working with a teletype printing terminal, they said, I wonder what we can use this character for. So a lot of languages spell out AND when they're trying to do a logical AND. C and C++ used the double ampersand. Instead of using an OR, typing OR like a lot of other languages, C and C++ used the vertical bar. Here's three slides of special characters and their uses. Parentheses, we're going to use those for math expressions and function arguments. The curly braces identify blocks of code or data. The square brackets are used to identify arrays. Angle brackets are used to locate the compiler's directory for include files, or less than cout, or greater greater for cn. The double quotes indicate a project directory or could indicate a string constant. Single quotes are for defining a single character. The percent sign, well, that's to compute a remainder for an integer division. The forward slash, compute a quotient for a division. Or, if you're using floating point values, then it's the full quotient, including the decimal places. The backslash is a special character, and that one is used for escape sequences inside of character strings. So, we'll cover that in a minute. Then, there is the exclamation mark. That is a not. The tilde is a ones complement. That flips every bit. The asterisk is used for multiplication and pointer declaration or dereference. The minus sign is for subtraction. The underscore, well, we can use that as a pretend like it's a space. The period is a separator in numbers for like 145.338, or it's used as a separator for structured data and classes. The comma, combine more than one statements together. Semicolon marks the end of a statement. The colon, together with the question mark, is the selection operator. And it's also used for labels and classes. Then we have a bunch of other ones. The hash mark is a preprocessor directive like pound include. The ampersand is a logical and a bitwise and, the address of operator and a reference declaration. The vertical bar is for ORs. The caret is a logical exclusive OR. The question mark together with the colon make the selection operator. The at sign and the dollar sign, I haven't seen those used. They're probably around somewhere. To consider are the escape sequences. Inside of a character string or a character definition, backslash N means new line, backslash R means return. So a return brings you all the way back to the beginning of the line, where backslash N brings you down to the next line. We also have things like backslash A, stands for announce. The old teletypes that ring the bell. On a regular terminal, it just goes beep. Backslash T is a tab, moves to the next 8th position on the screen or on the printer. So check those out. If you want to print or display a backslash, then inside of a character string, you need to do backslash, backslash, and that will create a single backslash inside of the character string. Now, since character strings start off and end with a quote, what do you do if you want a quote in the middle of a character string? Backslash quote. Or a single quote, backslash single quote. Hey, that makes sense. Well, I hope this helped and made some more sense too. Bye-bye.